Good morning, students. I'm Miss Smita Ganatra from Gundhawali Mumbai Public School, and today I'm going to take your civics subject. Now, before I start the chapter, let me ask you that have you seen your history textbook? There are some picture of different monuments in India. It is given on your cover page, and few of them I have brought for you. You have to identify the picture and name it. Okay.
Okay, miss.
Now come and see this picture. What is it?
Gateway of India.
Children, please raise your hand. I'll ask by your name. You have to answer then only. Okay. Now see this. Please, students, don't give correct answer. Okay.
Sir.
Now.
It's a Taj Mahal.
Yes, Taj Mahal. Yes, very good. Now say this.
Taj Mahal.
It's yes, India Gate.
India Gate.
What is Red
Fort?
Please, children, don't give correct answer. Now, Dhruva, tell me what is it?
Red Fort.
Miss Parliament House in New Delhi.
Okay. Now, children, please mute your mic. Whenever I'll ask you, just raise your hand and answer. Okay. Now, see, this is Parliament, right? So now, today we are going to take a look about introduction to the parliamentary system. Now say this, the building of the parliament. This is Indian Parliament. Now let me tell you that this building is designed by Sir Edmund Herbert Baker. And the first foundation stone was laid on 12 February 1921. Now let me tell you that this Sir Edwin and Herbert Baker has designed this building in year 1912 and 1930. In between this year, they have designed this building. But the first foundation stone was laid on 12 February 1921. And it took to complete 6 years. The construction completed by 6 years. And in 1927, 18th January 1927, the Governor General of India at that time, Sir Arvind, has inaugurated this building. And this building construction's cost was rupees 83 lakhs. At that time, it was 83 lakh of the construction cost. And secondly, this building is very big that it has covered 6 acres of land. Okay. Now, before we go ahead to understand what is Parliament, we'll see this picture and discuss few points. What is Parliament? So the Parliament system is the system of governance. Governance means the action or the motion of the governing state or organization. So the governance means the action on the motion which are taken by the organization or by state to govern the state or the organization's administration. Secondly, we can say the parliamentary is the type of legislature. Now, some might wondering what is legislature. So now let me tell you that the word legis has come from the Latin language. And the meaning of legis is means those who write laws, that is L-A-W-S, laws. Those who write laws, that is called legislature. So the legislature of the central government is known as the parliament. See, we are having state government as well as central government. Both where legislatures are there, but the legislature of the particularly central government is known as the parliament. Or we can say the legislature of a state or a country is a group of people who have the power to make and change laws. See, these people are having power to make changes in the laws for the beneficial of the country. For the welfare of the people, they can make or they can change the laws. Now, before we go ahead, let us discuss about the main branches of the government. Now, children, here are the main branches of the government. The first one is the legislature. The legislature is to make laws. See, this legislature people are making. Then, second branch is executive. And the work of executive is to implement laws. Whichever laws are made by legislature, executive are implementing those laws and see that it is properly working or not. Then comes the judiciary. Now, judiciary is to provide justice. Now, all three organs are working together. They are having connection in between. And the functions of this organ, their jurisdiction, and the limitation on their power, the interrelationship between these organs are decided by the Constitution. Now, our Constitution is written by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, as you know that. There are some rules and regulations and the laws. According to that, only the legislature are making laws, executive are implementing laws, and judiciary provides justice according to the Constitution. There are some instructions in the Constitution. So they are working as per the Constitution. Now, before we go ahead, let us see what are the types of government. Now, there are two types of government. One is parliamentary system and the other is presidential system. Now, we'll talk about first parliamentary system. Now, let me tell you, the word parliamentary has come from French word parler. And parler means to talk. And as we know that in parliamentary, lot of discussion takes place. People are talking whole day, discussing about country's issues or for the welfare of the public. So the word comes from French, that is parler, and it means to talk. So the parliamentary system of government developed primarily in England. Now see, from where it has started. So let me tell you that it has started from England. And as the English or British people were ruling over all whole country, they built many colonies in different places. And they started this parliamentary system. And the other thing, the English constitution is an unwritten constitution. That means it is not in written form. Whereas our Indian constitution is in written form, and Indian constitution is the longest and the largest constitution. Okay, now one will think, without written constitution, how any government can carry out all the governance? So this British government or English government, we can say that governance is carried out in accordance with the traditions, customs, and convention. That means the situation at that time and the tradition of them, they are governing according to the tradition and customs. Now see, this is the building of British Parliament. You can see the structure, see the design at that time, how they built their Parliament House. This is the inside of the Parliament House. This is British Parliament House. And we can say the parliamentary system of government having its roots in Parliament is considered as the contribution of England. So wherever parliamentary system is going on, their roots were built in the Parliament of England. So this is the England Parliament. Inside the Parliament, see the sitting arrangement and all the system. Now we'll move on to the characteristics of Indian parliamentary system. Now, first of all, in the parliamentary system, the Indian Parliament is composed of President, Lok Sabha, and Rajya Sabha. Can you identify this person? He is our current president.
Ramnath Kovind.
Yes, mute your mic. Everybody mute your mic now. So Ramnath Kovind is the current president. Then Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. These three organs are there. It is our parliament is composed with these three organs. Now, in the parliamentary system of government, the prime minister is the head of the executive. See, whereas parliamentary systems are there, the prime minister is the head of the executive. Now this is our Indian parliament. You can see the picture. This is our Indian parliament. So a parliamentary system of government is the one where representatives are directly elected by the people. The people who are sitting in this parliament, they are elected by the people, directly elected by the people. Then they are the members of the legislature. See, all the members who are sitting in the parliament, they are the members of the legislature. And before I told you that legislature means the person or the people who write the laws, which is known as the parliament. Now we can see another characteristics, that the members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. And the number of the member in the house is also fixed. Now, during election time, what happens? We'll see next. See that. Elections to the Lok Sabha are held at regular intervals. In India, every 5 years, we have Lok Sabha elections. Now, what is election? So, election is a type of competition only. Okay, election is a type of competition between the candidate of different political parties. All political parties contest this election. Now, here some of the parties' symbols I have put for you. Few are there, but in India, many more parties are there. Okay, so all the parties can take part in the election. Now, the party which gets more than half seats is considered as a majority party, and the majority party forms the government. Now, see, when elections held, after that, the result comes out, and at that time, the party which gets more than half, see the word more than half, you have to remember this word. So more than half majority seats won by any party, they can form the government. Now here you can see there are two colors people you can see, but the majority is of yellow color, right? And it is more than half, you can easily make out. So this party can form the government. But sometimes what happens, there is no majority. There is no majority, or you can say no clear majority. Some parties come together and they can establish the government. Now see the first picture. There are three different color peoples you can see. So maximum number, you can see that there are pink color. The second one is yellow and the third one is black. But here, in the last slide, we have seen that majority means more than half. But here, this pink color, they didn't prove the majority because it is not more than half. So what they did, these two parties come together. Here it is, that is yellow and pink color. They come together and they can establish the government. Now, this type of government is known as coalition government. Now, India has clear majority. Indian Lok Sabha has clear majority, and they form their party. But in Maharashtra nowadays, we can say this government is of coalition government, because Shiv Sena and Congress, they come together and they form the party. So when there is no clear majority, the two or more than two parties come together to form the government, that is known as a coalition party or coalition government. Now, the leader of the majority party becomes the prime minister. Now you can see that the leader of the BJP, Mr. Narendra Modi, as the BJP once majority, Narendra Modi sir became the prime minister of India. Now the prime minister and the council of minister forms the executive in the parliamentary system. Now there are different position, right? For different position, different person or different minister was selected by prime minister and the council ministers. Now here, executive has a dual responsibility in parliamentary system. This is characteristics of parliamentary system. So one of them is executive has a dual responsibility. Dual means two. Nowadays we are having our smartphone with dual SIM card, right? So we are putting there two SIM cards. So that way executive has a dual responsibility. That means they have to handle double responsibility. So one of them is to implement laws, because all these members are executive as well as the legislature. So they have to implement laws and fulfill the responsibility of the legislature. So they have to make the laws as well as they have to implement the laws. So this executive are doing double role. Now we can say, decision taken by any ministry or department is considered as a decision of the government. Now, there are different departments: education department, finance department, agriculture department, welfare department, then health department. Different departments are there, different ministers are there. But what happens if any single minister or any single department has taken some decision? That decision will be considered as a decision of the government. One cannot say this decision taken by the education department, so we are not responsible for that. No, it is not like that. If one department has taken any decision, that will be considered as a decision of the whole government. So the all government ministers and departments are responsible for that. Okay. Now next, we'll see that the discussions and deliberations are an integral part of the parliamentary of government. Now say discussion and deliberations. Here, for any issues of the government, of the country, discussion takes place. And in this discussion, opposition parties also take part in this discussion. They may support or point out shortcomings in the policies and laws. See, in the parliament, opposition party people are also sitting. Sometimes they support when the people are doing some good work. And if they thought it is good for country, good for the people, they will support. But sometimes when our parliamentary people are passing some laws or discussing about some policies, this opposition party can take point out, can take objection, and with the detailed study, they will point out the shortcomings. See what will happen if we plan this, what will be the next? So because of that, the laws can be made in a better way and fulfill the country's wishes and demands. So this is also deliberation and discussion, both are the integral part. We can say it is also important in parliament. Now we'll discuss about why India has adopted a parliamentary system of government. Now, as we know that before independence, Britishers ruled over India near about 150 years, right? And during that period only, the parliamentary institution started. Very first, I told you that the parliamentary system was built in England. Okay, and they have many colonies in different places of India. So the development of the parliamentary institution started during the British rule in India, and British ruled over 150 years in India, and the people were familiar with the rules and regulations and the functioning system, or how they're behaving, how they're treating, how they're administrating. The people were familiar with this. And secondly, what happened, that the constitution of assembly adopted this system after discussion. Now you can see here the constitution of India, that book is here, it is written by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, and the constitution has also adopted this system. Why? Because the people were familiar, the people were very much practice with this system, parliamentary system. And secondly, what they did, they made few changes after discussion. They made few changes in the parliamentary system to suit the Indian situation, Indian culture, Indian people. So some changes they made it in, and they adopted this parliamentary system. Now we'll talk about the presidential system of government. Now here you can see the parliamentary house of USA. Now the presidential system of government exists in countries such as United States of America. that this system is different from parliamentary form. See, our parliamentary form and presidential government is different. So what are the difference? We'll see later on. So this system is different from our parliamentary form. Here you can see the president of USA, Mr. Donald Trump. And on the right side, you can see the parliamentary house of USA. You can make out, see, there is a flag of this USA. You can make out this parliamentary belongs to USA. See the sitting arrangement. Okay. Now, in this system, the president is executive and is independent of the legislature. Now, here, president has more power. He is the president of, is the executive, as well as he can implement the laws also. So, he is independent of the legislature. Now, second thing, he is the head of the state or country. The president is the head of the state, or we can say a country. He is directly elected by the people. Now in India, we didn't give vote to direct Mr. Narendra Modi. We elected the representative of parties. Different area, different representative were standing for the election. We elected that representative, and as the majority of BJP persons or representative won the seats, that's why Mr. Modi became the prime minister. But in USA, I must say, Donald Trump, and against him was Hillary Clinton. So people directly vote for the Donald Trump or Hillary Clinton. Whereas in India, we elect representative. And among the representative, the leader of them became the prime minister. Whereas in USA, directly elected by the people, becomes the president of the country. Now, some features of the presidential system of government. The House of Legislature and the president are directly elected by the people. Okay, all the legislature person and the president elected by the people. Just now I discussed with you that Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, people directly voted for them. The second is, the president is the executive head and has lots of powers, including power to implement laws. Now here, president is having more power. He is the head of the executive. He has the power to implement laws. He has the power to make laws or change the laws. So the president has more power in presidential system. Now, in spite of such a structure, the legislature and the executive keep a check on each other. Now, see, in spite of they are different, but they are having check on each other. Check means they watch each other works, and if any faulty decision are taken, they immediately correct it. So they are known as the responsible government. See, this mutual control, because of the check, they have mutual control over each other, can lead to a responsible government. Now we'll see the difference between the parliamentary system and the presidential system. Now, president is the constitutional head. See, in India, we have president as well as prime minister. But in presidential system, there is no prime minister. President only works as prime minister. So, in India, we have president and he is the constitutional head. Whereas in presidential system, president is the executive head. Now, second difference between parliamentary system and presidential system is the prime minister and the council minister have more powers. We have seen that the legislature and all the member of the council and prime minister has more power in India. But in presidential system, president has more power. He only can make the laws. He only can implement the laws. So he is having whole and sole power in his hand. Now the third one, that is Council of Ministers, is formed by the elected members of parliament. Now Council of Ministers, people voted for the representative. They became the ministers of council, and among them only the elected people became the members of parliament. So that's why council of ministers is formed by the elected members. Okay, now this whereas in presidential system, president is directly elected by the people. In India, representative were elected, and the leader of the representative or that party became the prime minister. But here in presidential system, president is directly elected by the people. Now we'll see the next one, that is parliamentary system and presidential system. Again, this is the difference. Parliament can remove the prime minister by passing no confidence motion. Now see, in parliamentary system, if the prime minister's work is not fulfilling and not worth for the country's benefit or not for the welfare of the people, so at that time no confidence motion, that act is passed and the prime minister can be removed. But in presidential system, president can be removed only by impeachment. Now impeachment means is a process by which a legislature body charges against the government officials for bribery, or you can say for high crimes, and they can remove the president. Now the last one is the members of the executive are also the members of the legislature. Now those who are executive in our parliament, they are also member of the legislature. As I said, that executive are playing double role, right? So executive are also as a legislature also they are working. So in presidential system, legislature and executive are not dependent on each other. They are separate, but even though they are having watch or they are having check or they are having control on each other. Okay, by mutual understanding, mutual control is there. Now children, today we have seen the parliamentary system, right? One overlook we have taken. Now I'm going to ask you a few questions. So you have to answer this. You have to raise your hand and answer. I will take a name. Don't unmute everybody. Please don't unmute. Now see the first one. A parliamentary system of government has developed in Dash country. Now can you tell me?
England.
England.
Okay. England. Now the next is, in the presidential system, Dash is the executive head.
President.
Please
president.
Unmute your mic and say whenever I'll ask you. The third one, the English constitution is the Dash constitution.
Unwritten.
Don't repeat all, everybody. Please mute your mic.
Yes.
Now the last one is, when no parties get a clear majority, Dash government is formed.
Coalition.
Now please mute your mic. So now today what we learned about the Indian Parliament, that it was built in 1921. The first foundation stone was laid, and in 1927 the construction gets over, and Mr. Arvind, the general at that time, has inaugurated the building, right? And in the parliamentary system, we can see the parliamentary system is a type of government, type of legislature. And the functions of the parliament, that they are working for the beneficial of people. They can pass the law. There are three branches of government, that is legislature, executive, and the judiciary. And the legislature makes the laws, then the executive implements the laws, and judiciary provides the laws. After that, we have seen why India has adopted parliamentary system of government. So, because Britishers ruled over 150 years in India, so the Indian people were familiar with the procedure, with the functions, with the tradition, and constitution has also adopted after making some changes in the constitution. India has adopted the government, parliamentary system of government. And in the presidential system, we have seen that president has more power. He is the legislator, he is the executive, he is the head of the executive, and he has lots of power in his hand. And there is no prime minister, whereas in a parliamentary system, president is also there, as well as prime minister is also there. And prime minister and the council members are having more power in that system. I hope, children, you have understood this topic.
Thanks
for watching and thanks for attending.
Yes, miss.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, miss.
Bye, miss.
Okay.
Thank you, miss.
Okay. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, miss.
See you in the next chapter.